This is a very big deal for Xreal with a big partner. What was the logic behind doing it?
Okay, so first of all, I don't think it's not just a big deal for us. I think it's a big deal for the future of AR on Android. Finally, speaking of the spatial computing, I feel like all the pieces are ready. The hardware is ready, form factor is right, and the platform is ready, ecosystem is there, and most importantly, Gemini. AI, we believe, is going to make the whole XR experience so much better to the next level. So that's why we're so excited to see this coming.
When's it coming? Tell me about the product. Like, how real is this in terms of when a consumer or a developer can get their hands on the hardware?
I think a developer will get them, as soon as, the end of this year.
Is that it?
No, this is
Okay.
the current generation, Xreal One Pro, the one you tried last time.
For our audience, there's a set of glasses on the desk in front of us, but that's not it. Keep going.
So we believe, for the consumer, it's going to be early 26.
Has the relationship with Google allowed you to accelerate your go-to-market on a new product?
Absolutely, absolutely. And this is the first time I believe you're going to have this, for spatial computing, you're going to have this end-to-end experience. And you got a chance to try all the first-party Google applications on XR as well.
Meta. I am a Ray-Ban Meta's user regularly. That is not a VR AR set of glasses. They're smart glasses.
That's
But
right.
as you know, I spent a bit of time with Project Orion, right? Augmented reality glasses. Why or why not is your offering going to compete with that? Is it similar? Why is it dissimilar?
Okay, I won't say it's a competition, but I really enjoy working with Google because I believe the last, missing pieces will be ecosystem.
Right.
And Google always offer a really open, developer-friendly kind of ecosystem.
Right.
And, the fairy line I like about Android XR is if you already develop on Android, you develop on Android
Well,
XR.
how simple should we make this for the Bloomberg Technology audience, right? Android, from a smartphone perspective, or in cars, the OS is everywhere around the world. So you're basically arguing that I'm going to make the Android smart glass simple.
That's right. I think, if you look at the success of Android, Google just want to repeat that for XR. And, this time they recognize they need to work with a lot of other kind of OEM partners, and starting with Samsung. Project Mohan will be the first XR devices. And, we have Xreal, we have even Gentle Monster, Warby Parker announcing yesterday as well. I see we're putting alliance, working together to deliver a variety of different kind of devices for Android XR.
I've got a question for you from our audience. When I
Sure.
said on social media you're coming on the show, this is from @VR_Tonio on X. Can you ask them if the new X1 Pro needs the Beam Puck for a spatial experience? It is vague on your website.
Well, okay, so for Xreal, we always have two different product visions. One is what we call spatial display. It's basically an easy-to-connect accessory that can plug into virtually any devices, right? And then there's another one, what we call spatial computing, which is end-to-end experience, just similar to Orion or maybe even Apple Vision Pro.
Real quick, financials. How much money are you making right now? Do you need to raise money? How's that looking?
Okay, so we do have a plan to go public in 26.
Okay, where?
So, definitely in the US.